Voices of Vista.
Someone who's willing, someone to care, someone who's needed and glad to be there, someone to give of himself for a year.
Guitarist Gabor Szabo and the John Kakavas Orchestra and Chorus. These are the voices of Vista, volunteers in service to America. All over America, in slums, migrant worker camps, Indian reservations, wherever opportunity is needed. That's where Vista volunteers go.
Someone who's young and someone who's old, hands that are willing and hearts that are bold. Someone to give what is priceless and dear, a Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer.
I'm Willis Conover. Now meet our guest. Gabor Szabo.
Thank you, Willis. It's a pleasure to be here for Vista. We would like to open the set with an old favorite of mine, Witchcraft.
Witchcraft, Gabor Szabo.
Thank you.
Witchcraft by guitarist Gabor Szabo, our voice for Vista. He'll be back in just a moment. A chain, they say, is no stronger than its weakest link. A nation is only as rich as its poorest citizen. In the United States, the richest country in the history of the world, there is still poverty. There are still people trapped in a prison so frustrating, the walls might as well be a mile high, and the prosperity might as well be a million miles away. Somehow it's just not for them. But that's not the way it will always be. This is the land of opportunity, and slowly but surely, that's coming to mean opportunity for everyone. That's what Vista volunteers try to do. They go somewhere to live for a year with poverty. They work on both the effects and the causes of poverty. They bring opportunity with them. They come to spread some good luck around in places where there hasn't been very much good luck before. Find out how you can become a Vista volunteer. Write Vista, Box C, Washington, D.C. Our voice for Vista, Gabor Szabo.
Yes, thank you, Willis. As you probably know, you know, Witchcraft was made popular by a favorite singer of mine, if not the all-time favorite, Frank Sinatra. And recently, about a year ago, he's done another song which impressed me to a point where I felt like I would like to also perform the tune, the title of which is It Was a Very Good Year.
It was a very good year for Sinatra and for Gabor Szabo, who plays it now. It was a very good year. Voice for Vista is Gabor Szabo. He'll be back in just a moment. We've placed a phone call to a Vista volunteer in Barberville, Kentucky, Mrs. Vanetta Mecklenburg. Mrs. Mecklenburg, how did you happen to join Vista?
I suppose there were various things. I had tried earlier to join the Peace Corps, mm-hmm. and through some little discrepancy in my medical history, they would not recommend me for overseas duty, but they did suggest Vista. I am a grandmother. And since I had just lost my husband and my family was gone, I just thought it was a very fine time to spend a year or two in Vista.
Well, Mrs. Mecklenburg, you've told us that you think being in Vista is a rewarding experience. Can you tell us in what way?
A broadening in personality, an understanding of another culture. A bit rewarding in seeing the response of people. A feeling that maybe you've contributed a little bit to somebody's well-being.
You say another culture. Why another culture?
Well, probably I would say 80% of the people here are living in substandard homes. That in itself is a different culture, an adjustment to a situation of that kind. A situation where maybe a family of from 8 to 12 or 15 living in from 2 to 4 rooms, certainly that is different. An area where basic education is not a part of their life or has not been, so that we have many, many, many families, heads of families, who neither read nor write.
Well, the work you're doing there in adult education will make a difference in the long run. Thank you very much, Mrs. Mecklenburg. Vanetta Mecklenburg, a Vista volunteer. Our voice for Vista, guitarist, and on this program, sitarist as well, Gabor Szabo. And in case, I don't suppose there isn't anyone who didn't notice that you're speaking with a little accent, Gabor.
Well, I have a tendency of forgetting about it, Willis, but you know, every once in a while I'm reminded, especially, you know, when I'm trying to introduce some songs that have a more complicated title. But it's been 11 years, you know, and I have a tendency of thinking like an American every once in a while, you know, until the accent gives me away.
Do you care to identify the accent?
Oh, I think we should. It's Hungarian. By the way, this time, Willis, I think I should explain, you know, for those of us, or those of you who don't know what a sitar is. Sitar is a string instrument, not unlike the guitar. The only difference is that actually it's a much more complex instrument than the guitar. Guitar has 6 strings, and even though I used to think it was very hard to play it, I didn't know what hardship was until I tried to play a sitar, which has 4 melody strings and also has two to four strings that I use just for bass notes and just play it open. You never finger it, in other words. And then underneath there are anywhere from 14 to 18 sympathetic strings which pick up the resonation of the notes that I'm playing on the top, and they sort of, that is actually what gives the drone-like effect.
Well, Gabor, would you demonstrate that that performance on Walking on Nails, where you play sitar, you play guitar, and you also sing as if you were a drone accompanying an Indian musical group?
More than happy to, Willis. Here's Walking on Nails.
Gabor Szabo. Thank you. Walking on Nails, sung and played on guitar and sitar by Gabor Szabo.
You know, Willis, organizations like Vista are very important, because if some young people, you know, who get involved with Vista, and they are able to project their enthusiasm and their idealism into those who have given up, you know, and by living with them and just spirit becoming sort of part of their lives, you know, I know that it's it can be very helpful, because these people who are directionless need somebody, and maybe those who aren't as lucky financially or having maybe parents who can guide them or people around them, you know, people who get involved with Vista and volunteer to do this job, I think doing a great service.
Perhaps Gabor Szabo has pointed a direction for you. If you're interested in finding out about Vista, write to V-I-S-T-A, Box C, Washington, D.C. Our voice for Vista, Gabor Szabo.
Yes, the next selections, I'm saying selections because we're combining two songs and playing it as a medley, are actually both French-oriented, also, although the first one is written by, pardon me the chauvinism, but written by a Hungarian, Joseph Kozma, who lived all his life, I think, in France. Autumn Leaves and Speak to Me of Love, which is an old French chanson, and I used to hear my parents actually humming it, and I was trying to combine these two French-oriented songs in the next medley, Autumn Leaves and Speak to Me of Love.
Gabor Szabo.
Thank you.
Autumn Leaves and Speak to Me of Love by Gabor Szabo. Thank you, Gabor.
Thank you, Willis. It was a great pleasure being here for Vista.
Our thanks also to the American Federation of Musicians and to this radio station for making the program possible.
Someone who's willing, someone to care, someone who's needed and glad to be there, someone to give of himself for a year.
Voices of Vista is produced by Arch Lustberg for the Office of Economic Opportunity. The audio engineer was Joe Bouguer. Find out more about Vista. Write to Vista, Box C, Washington, D.C. Now for Gabor Szabo, the John Kakavas Orchestra and Chorus, and Willis Conover. Goodbye.
Someone who's young and someone who's old, hands that are willing and hearts that are bold. Someone to give what is priceless and dear, a Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer, Vista volunteer.
This is an M.A. Mangum production.